Japan is, of course, earthquake country, and the people are very much afraid of earthquake. And if earthquake occurred, the impact is very, very strong economically and also to the life in Japan.
So this is a part of a fault zone in a deep ocean trench in Japan that had this big magnitude 9 earthquake in 2011, and it's in a spot that had a lot of slip. So the seafloor jumped essentially to the east, about 50 to 60 meters. And that's the big question that we have is, why is that? Having so much shallow part of the fault zone, slip has made it a much bigger earthquake than anyone expected, and it also created a much bigger tsunami than anyone expected.
Less than 1 year after the Tohoku-oki earthquakes in 2011, there was an expedition called SHIPAS, and I was part of that expedition that managed to go and drill into that sleeping fault zone. And we wanted to know, several years after that, how that fault was healing. So this is one of the main objectives of JTRACK, is to go back and to compare what we are seeing with the result that we have on JFAS.
This is a very technologically challenging project. I think we all know that we are at the kind of very limits of what is possible. And we are pushing those limits.
I think everyone is most excited about actually crossing the plate boundary itself. The plate boundary will be the interface between the rocks that underlie northern Japan and the rocks that underlie the Pacific Ocean and where they meet. And where they meet, that's actually the area that generates the earthquake.
I'm expecting this to actually see the fault from the logging, see the digit moving and see the geophysical logs indicating us that we are crossing and reaching that plate boundary fault.
I'm very confident that the drilling ship is going to amaze us again in terms of the engineering achievements that it's going to make during the time of that expedition.
The one of the very important scientific objectives, temporal time variation of the fault zone, especially in the shallow region where we got very large slip during the 2011 earthquake. So we would like to confirm if shallow part of fault zone is start rocking or not.
All these different things can really tell us a lot about the particular rock materials down there or the particular conditions, some of them geologic, some of them hydrologic. So if we can kind of understand it here where we have experienced a big earthquake and a large thing, we can take that knowledge and expand it to other subduction zones across the globe. And in that way, we can perhaps better be prepared for large earthquakes and tsunamis in other places.
The results from the expedition will really help us understand whether or not that fault that's off the coast of Japan is loading up and getting ready to generate another huge earthquake. And so an immediate outcome from that will be for the people who are living locally in Japan, for them to be able to understand what do they need to prepare for, and is it likely that there will be another large tsunami that's coming one day?